Minsan po kasi, ginagamit ng mga mandaraya na palusot yung mga PWDs o seniors para manipulahin ang kanilang balota. Kunwari, tutulungan nila yung senior. Pero sa totoo lang, gusto nilang ibahin ang ilalagay o isusulat sa balota. We need to provide accessibility and simultaneously safeguard the sanctity of their ballots. Finally, I fully support the bills amending the Omnibus Code such that the power to select office spaces for provincial and local elections officers be stripped from local government units. Dapat naman talaga COMELEC or at least ang national government ang pumipili at nagpapatayo ng kanilang opisina at hindi si mayor o si governor. Kaya minsan pagdating ng eleksyon, nauna pa si mayor na nagbibigay ng opisina na nakakaalam na resulta ng eleksyon. Kaya mas madali din manipulahin ang resulta ng eleksyon dahil utang na loob ni election supervisor ang magandang opisina na ibinigay ni mayor. We should put a halt to this practice and amend the law. We must uphold and preserve at all times the independence of our COMELEC and its officers. They must remain free from duress, or any form of undue influence in order to conduct free, fair, and honest elections. That's all, Madam Chair. Again, good morning and thank you po.
Yes, thank you very much for the spirited support given by our colleague this Monday morning. We're all raring to go. Thank you very much. At eto nga, hihingi kami ng update dito sa COMELEC. Maraming iba't ibang balita tungkol sa ating barangay elections. Unang-una, nagtataka kami kung bakit automated bigla ang pinilot test dito sa barangay at SK elections. Ang pagkaintindi natin, manual to. Kaya biglang bakit automated? Ang pagkaalam ko, magko-cost-benefit analysis kung kakayanin para sa mga malalaking barangay tulad sa Quezon City at iba pa kung saan na halos kalahating milyon, tama ba, kung minsan ang botante. Okay, tapos alam ko rin na Mebinaril, tama ba, na-ambush isang municipal election officer sa Maguindanao bago mag-Valentine's the day before. So we are hopeful that there's a quick report on this. I hope it has nothing to do with the upcoming barangay and SK elections. And finally, I think an election is about to be conducted this week. Is that correct? February 25 in Cavite for our now Secretary of Justice, Boying Remulla. So if you could apprise us of all these developments very briefly so that questions can be propounded as well thereafter. Thank you. We invite Chairman George Garcia. I believe you will make the presentation. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Madam Chair. Senator Pitulfo, gandang umaga po. As far as the COMELEC is concerned, we are almost 100% prepared for the barangay and SK election of October 30, 2023. As of today, we were able to print 86.59%. I repeat, 86.59% of the ballots for the regular voters. And as far as the Sangguniang Kabataan, we were able to print, as of today, 90.62% of all the ballots for the SK. And so we are hoping to be able to print everything, all the ballots, before the end of February.
I recall that last year you told us that some training had been conducted for teachers and other election officers who would supervise the conduct of both elections. Are they still in place or will continuous training be undertaken?
With all due respect, Madam Chair, as far as the training of the teachers are concerned, we had not yet proceeded with the training because of the possibility at that time that there will be postponement of the election. And so,
kala ko doon nagastos yung ilang gastos nung na-postpone. Natuloy yun?
Madam Chair, no. Doon po nagastos sa printing of the ballots including personnel services of the commission.
Pero magagamit naman yung mga balotang yun. Hindi naman sasayangin.
Yes, Your Honor. Madam Chair, last week, the COMELEC and Bank passed a resolution authorizing the use of the 13 million ballots for the regular voters and 8 million ballots for the SK, Madam Chair.
Yes, thank you. Sapat ba ito yung 5.7 na new appropriations ng 2023? Chine-check ko lang yung budget ninyo kasi doon tayo na para nung nakaraang taon dito sa tungkol sa budget ng pagpo-postpone. So Chairman, is there any update on that development?
Madam Chair, as far as the Comelec is concerned, barangay and SK election, the national government gave us 8.449 billion pesos for the conduct of the barangay and SK election, supposedly by December 5, 2022. However, because of the postponement, the budget as approved by the Senate and the House of Representatives and assigned by the President, the 5.7 does not contain, Madam Chair, the additional budget for the barangay and SK, because accordingly in the law it says it will be the subject of a continuing appropriation and supplemental appropriation.
So how do you seek to finance this barangay and SK elections coming shortly? The only new appropriations, as you mentioned, are the 5.7 billion already stated as new appropriations for COMELEC. Wala nang iba pa. Although, as we're well aware, you have continuing appropriations from the previous year as well as savings and other monies.
That's right, Madam Chair. As far as the COMELEC is concerned, of the 5.7, 1.250 was allotted for the construction of our COMELEC building. And dun po sa kakulangan, kung ano man po, because during the previous hearing, we said that perhaps we will be spending more or less additional 2.8 billion pesos. So gagawa na lang po namin ng paraan, Madam Chair, mula sa COMELEC savings, additional the budget remaining with the commissioner elections. We're going to still wait, Madam Chair, for the report of our field personnel for the pilot, for the project of precincts. Doon po namin malalaman, Madam Chair, if we're going to add the precincts and or ilan yung mga voters per precinct.
Ito nga ang inaalala ko, katulad ni Senator Tulfo, na kapag nagkulang ng budget ang COMELEC, ang tinatakbuhan yung LGU. Kaya nagkakaroon ng collusion, conspiracy, nakakapraning na eh. Dahil dito, nais natin malaman, at if I may request from Chairman George, exactly where and how much will be derived from your other sources such that we can be assured that this will be a fair and free election, not financed by random political forces.
Thank you very much, Madam Chair, Your Honor. Definitely the COMELEC, we will commit, the COMELEC will not be asking for any help from any LGU because that's prohibited. What we can only ask from the LGU support from the for the conduct of plebiscites, but not the conduct of regular election, even special election. So the remaining,
Pero kasasabi mo lang kulang yung budget na ipigay sa inyo, pati yung new appropriations ninyo, hindi sapat. So saan manggagaling? Although nga, meron naman kayong savings at saka continuing naman yan. At meron rin kayong iba't ibang collection, di ba? So may pagkukunan, ganun ba?
Yes, Madam Chair. And likewise, we reserve the right to respectfully ask our Congress for an additional budget as the need arises, simply because, Madam Chair, at this point, we can just estimate, but we cannot particularly pinpoint how much we're going to need, simply because although there were additional 1.6 million registered voters from December 12 to January 31, hindi pa po sinasubmit ng mga tao namin from the field kasi po meron pang Election Registration Board hearing by March. So, and doon pa po namin malalaman kung yung buong 1.6 approved po ba yon o meron pong o eksakto po bang approved yung 1.6 o may mababawasan, and then ilan po yung madadagdag sa bawat presinto o magkikreate po ba ng additional precincts.
So that being the case, may I reiterate the request that the budget and the funding sources be submitted to this committee so that in the little time left, we are able to access the funds in time, as well as be clarified that no undue influence will be exercised by the local and other politicians involved.